Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
Cause where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
So clap your hands and dance along with us, yeah.
Welcome to Shiloh.
We're advancing the kingdom of God.
Welcome to Shiloh.
Yeah.
Advancing the kingdom of God.
Cause where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Welcome to Shiloh.
So come on, clap your hands and praise the Lord with us.
Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
Cause where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
So clap your hands and dance along with us, yeah.
Welcome to Shiloh. Shiloh,
advancing
the kingdom of God.
Cause where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
So come on, clap your hands and praise the Lord with us.
Welcome to Shiloh, advancing the kingdom of God.
Cause where the Spirit
Shiloh,
hands together, come on, y'all. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, not just today, but always, now and forever. Just today, but always, now and forever. Lord, I praise your name. Listen, I praise your name. I praise your name.
Your holy name.
I praise your name. Your holy name. I praise your name. Not just today, but always, now and forever. Lord, I praise your name. I praise your name.
Your holy name.
Not just today, but always, now and forever. Lord, I praise your name. Listen, when the praise go up, blessings come down. When the praise go up, blessings come down. When the praise go up,
praise go up,
blessings come down. When the praise go up, blessings come down. When the praise go up, listen, we got a few people here, so lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, make some noise. Come on, y'all. Hey. Come on, say, God's got a blessing for you.
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 Listen. Say yes. just today, but always, now and forever, Lord, I praise your name. Come on, give God your best praise. Come on, y'all. Come on, I believe today is a service. Come on. Y'all know how y'all do it on Sunday morning. Because what happens is on Sunday, you remember what you had to go through Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So think about January. You're thinking about what you've been through and how you made it from January, February, March, April, May, June, July. You made it. Come on, give God the best praise you know how. Hey. Come on, y'all, put your hands together like this. Come on. Listen, not just today, but always, now and forever, Lord. Lord, I pray. Come on, y'all. Come on, choir. Put your hands together. Get it like this. Come on. Hey, yeah. We're going to say it one more time. Listen, not just today, but always. Forever, Lord, Lord, I pray. Come on, y'all. Come on, choir. Put your hands together. Come on. It says where two and three are gathered, he is. And I believe we have more than two and three. Come on, y'all. Exceedingly, abundantly, above all. All you could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in you, God is able to do just what he said he would do. Every promise to you. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Don't put those hands together like this. Come on, y'all. Y'all know how they do it in church. Come on, put your hands together. He's able. Now here's the part where everybody can join in. Come on, say, God is able. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill every promise. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't. Come on, y'all. He's able. Come on, put those hands together. Come on, y'all. Yeah, said he's able. Oh, 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 oh. And we'll say it again. Come on, y'all. Say, God is able. God is able. God, just what said he's gonna fulfill every. Don't give up on. He's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. exceedingly, abundantly, above all we could ask or we think. He's able. Don't give up. Don't give in. Cause he made a way. I love him. Cause he keeps on making a way. He sustained us. He kept me from A to B. He's able. I will continue to praise the Lord. He's able. He's able. With all that is. All that is. Within me I will. He's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. He's got you, yeah. In the very palm of his hand. Don't give up. Don't give in. He's able. He's able. He's able. He's able. Don't give up on God, cause he won't give up on you. Hey, come on, y'all. Don't give up on God, cause he won't give up on you. Come on, y'all, say, don't give up. One more time, say, don't give up.
Don't give up on God.
Cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Come on, he is able. He is able. He is able. He is able. He is able.
Good morning, my beautiful brothers and sisters. I am so honored and excited about having an opportunity to deliver God's word on today. I definitely give God all the honor, all the praise and glory from my great pastor, my husband, the Reverend Dr. Robert F. Cheeks Jr. If you could help me celebrate God for him as if we were all together in the house. We thank the Lord for our leadership. We thank the Lord for our great officers, our deacons and deaconess and trustees. Thank you, Lord. We also give God all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory for all of our visitors near and far and all of our beautiful members. What a blessing it is to be with you all today as we get ready for the Word of God. So if you don't already have your Bibles, I'm sure you do because we've been lifting up the Word already. But if you perhaps just you don't have it in your hand right now, I want to ask that you get your Bible, whether it's on your phone or your actual Bible book, and turn pages with me. Turn to the book of Numbers. We're going to go to Numbers chapter 23. And I'm going to be reading verses 16 through 20. I thank God for my family near and far. And thank you all for all of your prayers for my mom and my father in love. And just thank you for your support, your encouragement. All of the angels out there, you know who you are. We thank the Lord for each of you. Thank you. So again, we're going to read Numbers chapter 23, verses 16 through 20. I'm reading today from the New International Version. And if we're all ready, I can't hear any pages turning. I missed that. Let's read beginning at verse 16. And it reads, "The Lord met with Balaam and put a word in his mouth and said, 'Go back to Balak and give him this word.' So he went to him and found him standing beside his offering with the Moabite officials. Balak asked him, 'What did the Lord say?' Then he spoke his message, 'Arise, Balak, and listen. Hear me, son of Zippor. God is not human that he should lie, not a human being that he should change his mind. Does he speak and then not act? does he promise and not fulfill? I have received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot change it. The word of God has been read for the people of God, and it is indeed blessed. Now let's look to the Lord in prayer. If you would please close your eyes and bow your heads with me. Dear God, we thank you for this great day. Lord God, we thank you for the opportunity to gather together, to listen to what you have for us, God, a prepared word that's straight from you. God, I ask that you would have your way in me, this country girl. Lord, speak to me, speak through me, and speak for me. Have your way that someone might draw closer to you because of you. God, this word has nothing to do with anything other than what you would have it to do. God, we thank you for your word. God, we thank you for your love. We thank you for just being God all by yourself. Lord, again, have your way. It's in Jesus' name that we pray and believe. Let us all say amen, amen, amen. God bless you all. So I want to tag this text this morning with the title, Challenges Come, Yet God Remains the Same. Look at your neighbor and tell them, challenges come, yet God remains the same. My brothers and sisters, the text I read in your hearing sets the stage for us to witness a theatrical setup for a set aside time such as this. We have three different characters on the scene that we're going to examine closely. See the scene with me. The location is Moab. Come on, y'all, let's treat this like a vacation, amen? The location is Moab, which is above the Dead Sea and near Mount Nebo, which is in the location of Moses' death with rolling hills all around. Can y'all see it with your mind's eye? Come on and travel this morning with me. The characters, as I read in your hearing, are King Balak, the Israelites, and the pagan prophet Balaam. As we move through the hills of Moab in our mind's eye, let's discover together who are we most like in these characters. First, we have the trembling king of Moab, Balak. Balak heard about the Israelites coming out of Egypt by large numbers. Oh, y'all, it was a lot of them, okay? Verizon Network had nothing on the Israelite. It was a lot of folks. He was terrified, y'all. Just knowing about them without even knowing of any harm they were planning to bring to him directly or his people. Come on, y'all, stay with me. Did you hear me in the back when I said he heard about the Israelites coming? He hadn't gotten word that they were going to do this or that to them. No, he just heard about them coming. King Balak heard about the Israelites and how God was blessing them and how large they were, and he was planning against them. Balak, just like many of us, can hear about a thing and react before a thing is really a thing. Oh, did y'all hear me? Somebody didn't hear me. Pay attention. Balak, just like many of us, can hear about a thing and react to a thing before it really is a thing. Come on, somebody. Okay, here's the next character. Did you see yourself in Balak? I don't know. Second, we have the Israelites. Wow, the Israelites were on the move. They had been separated in tribes by way of a census and moving sometimes, as you know, in disobedience, which led them to many years of being lost. Oh, come on, somebody. Did you hear what I said? They had been operating and moving many times in disobedience, which led to them being what we know as wanderers. Does that sound like anybody in the house other than myself? There are times that I wasn't being obedient to God and I found myself lost, just bumping into walls left and right, not doing and going where God had intended for me to go, taking a long way to where I was really supposed to get to much quicker. Okay, that's who I'm talking about. Even still, God was remaining the same to them. God was still providing manna for them. God was still holding on to the promises he made way back when talking to Abraham in Genesis about the promised land. Yeah, our God is so good. The Israelites, y'all might remember, took down many armies and tribes as they were moving. And I guess Balak heard about it, y'all. Y'all know how the rumor mill is. It only takes one or two people before that story is gone. Amen? That's right. King Balak heard about what was going. Okay, that's our second character. Now let me come and get you to talk about the third character. Here we have Balaam on the stage. Balaam steps up on the stage, a pagan prophet that was away in a faraway land. Balaam, check it, was being hired by Balak, the king, to place a malediction, we call it a curse, on the Israelites. King Balak was offering big money, y'all. I'm talking about big money, to Balaam to join him in his avenge against the Israelites that he heard was coming, that hadn't quite made it to him or his people. He only heard about it. And because he heard about it, he sent for the pagan prophet Balaam to come and curse the people. Come on, somebody. There's somebody who heard about you. There's somebody who knows the anointing that's on your life. There's somebody who knows that you've been created to do greater things. There's somebody who heard about you. And just because they heard about you, they are setting up things and traps in your way that you're going to have to jump over, baby. You're going to have to go around some things because what God has for you is for you. But what I want you to catch in these characters, that sometimes all it takes is for somebody to hear about you and how God is blessing you and the things God has in store for you, even while you're being disobedient. There are people that are designed to try to distract you. There are people who are on the map that are trying to distract you and take you off course, but you got to keep going. Look at your neighbor and say, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. My brothers and sisters, now that we have examined the characters in our text for this set aside time, let's delve into the text. Oh, y'all, I'm so excited. In verse 16, in summary, the Lord met with Balaam and put a word in his mouth. When Balaam returned to Balak, he found Balak standing next to the offering with the good Moab officials. Balak asked him in the text, what did the Lord say? What did the Lord say? What did the Lord say? Now, brothers and sisters, don't lose sight. I did remind you of what's in the text. Balaam, the prophet, came back, from Bible study. He came back from Bible study. It said he had been with the Lord. He came back from Bible study. Oh, maybe he came back from the prayer meeting. Maybe he came back from a meeting at church of different sorts. But in the text, it says he came back from a meeting with the Lord. His time with the Lord. He came back and the king and the church officers. Oh, excuse me. Did I say church officers? Oh, I meant the church members. No, sorry. I meant Moab officials were standing by the offering to the Lord. Remember, this whole thing started off because of some foolishness. Did y'all hear me? Because of some foolishness, King Moab operated in a spirit of fear, false expectations of something appearing real. Come on. And anxiousness and pulled others into his foolishness. Oh, somebody better hear me on today. There's somebody in your circle, somebody in your neighborhood that is being caught up in some tricks of the enemy and some foolishness, and baby, they've pulled you into it. You don't even really know because you refuse to stay woke, and now you're operating in some foolishness instead of your faith. Oh, come on, let's look back at the story. The Israelites hadn't even made it to Balak, hadn't even made it to Moab, hadn't even made it to D.C., hadn't even made it to McLean, Springfield, Chantilly, Akakee, Clinton, Oxon Hill, hadn't even made it, and he's already stirring up foolishness that he's now putting before God to bless. Oh, come on, somebody. Can we stop putting a mess in front of God to bless? Come on, somebody. I came here today to help somebody this morning, brothers and sisters. The thought of the Israelites coming caused Balak some challenges. Hit yourself on the chest and say, I got some challenges. I got some challenges, but he forgot that God remains the same. The first thing Balak and we have to do when challenges comes our way, brothers and sisters, is we got to remember we have to surrender deeply within before reaching out. Yes, we've got to surrender deeply within before reaching out. We must surrender within ourselves. We must open up those hearts of ours. We got to open up our hearts wide for healing to receive help from God. Oh, my brothers and sisters, I know many of us have been going to church for years. We've been showing up at Sunday school. We've been showing up at Bible study. And we wonder why we still have crust around our hearts. We're wondering why we haven't received the healing that brother so-and-so received and sister so-and-so. We're wondering why we're stuck. It's because we are coming to the house. We're coming into the presence of the Lord. We sit down and we study the Bible, but we forgot to open up our hearts. Oh, Yolanda Adams sings it the best. We've got to open up our hearts. We've got to come into the presence of God with a posture, with a presence to receive from God. It's imperative for us to fully let go of our own agendas. I said it. We got to let go of our own agendas and our fabricated foolishness so that we can really let God come in. As we go throughout this week, brothers and sisters, let's not forget this stage. King Balak birthed all of this from a place of fear within. This scenario particular is of him sending for a prophet, Balaam, to come and curse the Israelites was all because he operated on his own instead of looking to God first. Where are the Balaks in the house today? Oh, is that you standing over in the kitchen trying not to hear the word of God, but you know you hear it? Is that you sitting on the couch behind the other couch trying to not hear the word, but you know you feel God tugging at your heart? Where are the Balaks in the house today? You know those who are stirring up foolishness before it is even a foolish thing in front of you? Come on, my brothers and sisters. We got to do better today. We got to do better today. I'm just got to believe that maybe, just possibly, if King Balak and some of us had gone to God first, just maybe God would have given him and us what we needed to survive whatever is concerning us. Somebody's got to talk to their boss tomorrow. Somebody's got a doctor's appointment. Somebody has a pending court case. And I just want to know if you won't just try something different. Instead of stirring up all these things that haven't happened, could we just possibly have a little talk with Jesus first? Could we possibly just trust that God already has it worked out? You know God has already overcome the world. You know that God has written the Holy Script. You do know that God is Alpha and Omega. We do know that God is Elohim. We do know this, right? So we got to do what we know we must do. Instead of spiraling out of control like Balak and doing surface things, you know, we do surface things in an attempt to manipulate God. Y'all remember, I know my husband and I are not the only movie buffs out here. We love the movie Shrek. Does anybody else remember Shrek? Do y'all remember that scene in Shrek when the donkey was jumping up and down saying, pick me, pick me? He was doing foolish things so he could be set apart. Oh, my brothers and sisters, if you're posting, post this. We got to give up our plans. Give in to God and watch God show out. Oh, I got to say that again. We got to give up our plans, give in to God, and watch God show out. I remember my husband preached a sermon years ago that talked about doing the ridiculous, how God will do the ridiculous. And my brothers and sisters, we have yet to see all that God can do in our lives. We just got to give in to him. We got to stop trying to do what we want to do and just give in to God. Hallelujah. We must stop turning cartwheels in the presence of God and thinking it's going to move God. God moves when God wants to move, how God wants to move, and just anytime God wants to move, he's going to move regarding the things pertaining to us. We must seek God first in the kingdom of God. My brothers and sisters, we must pray without ceasing. We can't give up. Okay, let's keep going. Check this out. So now there's a conversation going on, y'all, between the prophet and the king. Verse 18 says, Balaam is now back from going to speak with the Lord. He had come through all those hills. Bless his heart. Bless his heart. Bless his heart. He caught up in some foolishness, having to travel all through these hills and through who knows what over some stuff that hadn't even happened. How many of y'all are going through things that we really shouldn't be going through? Just because we've gotten entangled in somebody else's sin. Oh, come on, somebody. Verse 18 says, Balaam is now back from going to speak with the Lord. Balaam is telling King Balak what the Lord says. He tells Balak in my words. This is just my words. Man, Balak, get up and shut up. In his words, according to the biblical text, he says, arise, Balak, and listen. Listen. How many of us today are ignoring the voice from the Lord when the Lord is telling us to stand up and listen? Verse 19, God is not human that he should lie, not a human being that he should change his mind. Does he speak and then not act? Does he promise and not fulfill? Oh, when our challenges come, my brothers and sisters, we must remember God is not looking for fans. God is looking for obedience. God is not Kanye West. Come on, somebody. God is not looking for any fans. God is looking for our obedience. Somebody hear me today. Brothers and sisters, God is not amused by our verbal communication. Oh, come on, come on. We can shout. We can sing, we can turn cartwheels, we can flip over the pews, we can do all of that kind of stuff. We can tell folks a billion times over all the nice things we do daily. We can try to get the credit. We can tell them how involved we are in our church, how much we're doing in our communities. But baby, if we're not obedient to him, we're only his fans. We've yet to become his followers. Come on, somebody. We must be obedient to God. If God says the things we says a thing, we have to believe it. We must operate in faith, knowing what God says will come to pass. That's obedience. Look at your neighbor and say, that's obedience. God is not a liar. The text just said it. God says we are the lender and not the borrower. God said that and I believe it. God said that he will be with us. God said he will protect us. God said he will be our strength. God said he will be our peace. God said he will be our provider. God said he will always love us. God said it. And y'all, I'm a crazy country girl that believes it. Oh, God is going to be there for us. God loves us in spite of us. Let's be obedient and believe it. We're not alone. We're not out here without some hope. We're not lost just wandering around not knowing that we have someone who will give us instructions. God has written the biblical text to tell us what to do. And when we don't know what to do, we can go to God in prayer and ask God to tell us what to do. We got to understand we are not out here without hope. So we got to act like we know. Hold your head up, put your chin up, and know that you are a child of God. And God did not bring us this far to leave us now. God has given us all that we needed to run on and see what the end's going to be. He spoke it. We must act. He promised he will fulfill. We got to know that we know about the God that we say we serve. All right, we're almost done. Verse 20, Balaam tells Balak, y'all, I have received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot change it. Oh, come on, come on. Brothers and sisters, come up real close to me. When the challenges come to us this week, and they will come, the word of God says we will have trials and tribulations. I want you to remember this. when the trials come, I want you to remember what God blesses can't be blocked. What God blesses can't be blocked, can't be broken, and it sure can't be stopped. Did y'all hear what I said? Let me give it to you one more time, because there's somebody out there that's doubting. There's somebody out there that's having a pity party, and baby, you got to come out. Look at your neighbor and say, come out of that foolishness that you've made up in your mind. You got to understand, whatever God blesses, it can't be blocked. It can't be broken, and it can't be stopped. If God said it, baby, you better start believing it. You better walk like you know who God is. God is controlling everything pertaining to you. Whatever we're in right now, God is trying to produce something. If we're struggling, God is producing strength. Oh, my God. Y'all got to understand that God is producing some things. And when God is producing some things, sometimes God will take us through some things. Oh, you don't believe me? Why don't you go ahead and have a conversation with Job? Come on. God remains the same no matter whatever we go through. His word will not return void. Isaiah reminds us in chapter 55, verse 11, he tells us, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which it was sent. Come on, what God blesses can't be blocked, can't be broken, and it sure can't be stopped. Come on, did somebody hear me on today? That encourages my spirit on today. I know I'm not the only one that's got some prayers out there. You're believing God to show up and show out. You're trusting God to work it out. You're trusting God to go before you to make all the crooked ways straight. God can't be stopped. God may watch us make some wrong turns out of our own disobedience. But he said we will come out of this. Baby, we are coming out of this. God's grace really is sufficient. It doesn't matter what your doctor said. It doesn't matter what your lawyer, your manager. It doesn't matter what anybody else said. What did God say? If God spoke a thing, we got to understand it's our responsibility to act on that thing. I don't care how people say you're crazy. I don't care if God tells you to show up and do a thing, baby, you better show up. And know that God is going to do just what God said he's going to do. Oh, we got to act on that thing. Y'all come closer. Can y'all imagine what would have happened if Moses, y'all remember Mo? Y'all remember the murderer? What would have happened if Moses hadn't acknowledged the burning bush? What would have happened if Moses didn't listen? Oh, what would have happened if Paul, you know, the one who had been killing folks? Oh, come on, Paul hadn't surrendered on Damascus Road. What would have happened if the woman with the issue of blood wouldn't have come out of her house when she heard about a man named Jesus? Oh, my goodness, what would have happened? What would have happened? Oh, my goodness, what would have happened if the Lord didn't go through the beatings, the ridicule, being spat on, being hurt, being nailed on the cross? My brothers and sisters, I came to tell y'all that we are created to do what God has created us to do. We're going to have trials and tribulations. We're going to have to go through some hills. We're going to have to climb. We're going to have to cry. We're going to have to do everything that God created us to do. But baby, you're going to come out. And when you come out, you're going to come out stronger. You're going to come out wiser. You're going to come out with more faith. You're going to come out knowing God better than you knew him last year. We got to remember God's word is still the same. I came to tell somebody on this morning, the blood of Jesus still carries the same power. I don't care what challenge you have. God is still the same. The blood still works. The blood still heals. Oh, I heard somebody say the blood still saves. The blood still covers. The blood still strengthens. The blood still forgives. The blood still protects. Come what may. My brothers and sisters, God remains the same. I don't care what challenges we go through. I don't care how many nights we have to stay up crying ourselves to sleep. My brother and my sister, God remains the same. Brothers and sisters, thank you for delving deeper into the Holy Scriptures with me today. Thank you for walking through the texts Thank you for vacationing with me in Moab. Thank you for traveling up and down the hills as we learn about the king and the prophet, the pagan prophet and the Israelites. Thank you for opening up your heart to hear what the Lord has for us. I invite you to go to our website, Shiloh Baptist. I invite you, if you haven't accepted Jesus in your heart, I invite you to knock the crust off that thing. It's been hard for a long time. Oof. You've been walking around angry and depressed and no hope. Aren't you tired of living like that? I know how it feels because I lived like that before. My brothers and sisters, many of us will tell you we met a man named Jesus when we were lost, deep in sin, who reached way down to pick me up, turn my life around, and start me on my way again. But when I started on my way again, brothers and sisters, I walked differently. I talked differently. Ooh, God bless my life. So if I'm talking to you on today and you desire to open your heart, accept Jesus in your heart, confess your sins just as I did, our pastor did, our officers and members have done, I want you to go on our website and become a virtual member. I promise we'll love on you. We're a great body of believers. We love people. We love to love on people. We are not short of that, even in a pandemic. So again, thank you for joining us today. Shiloh Baptist Church, McLean, where our pastor is the Reverend Dr.